Yeah, hello everyone, all the miles and milers. Actually, I'm going to talk about there was one question in the group like what kind of nutrition should be taken if you are going for a 100-kilometer ride. So yeah, generally people who are training for cycling, long distance cycling, or people who are training at to do a Ironman, generally they would go for a 100 or 100 plus kilometer ride on a Saturday or a Sunday. So basically, yeah, nutrition is can be divided into two things. First of all, like if you are going for a 100 kilometer ride on Sunday, so you should have a very good adequate dinner on Saturday night. So that will actually give fuel your muscles. It will actually load all the glycogen into your muscles and into your liver so that you are ready actually for a 100-kilometer ride on Sunday morning. And before going for a very long ride, early morning before the ride, you should have a breakfast. Means not very heavy breakfast, but a breakfast in which you can actually eat boiled potatoes, or you can have peanut butter bread, or you can even have something like a porridge. So that can also work well, and then you actually go for a 100 kilometer ride. So during the ride, actually you will actually need at least 300 to 400 calories per hour. Like if you are cycling for 4 hours, like at an average speed of 25 kilometer per hour, you will be actually on the cycle for 4 hours. So how do you actually fuel yourself for 4 hours? So fueling yourself for 4 hours means you should carry chocolates, or you should carry banana, or you should carry energy bar. So generally, any kind of an energy bar or a chocolate will give you around 250 to 300 calories. So that means you should have at least one and a half energy bar or two chocolates in per hour if you are riding for 100 kilometers. So for 4 hours, you will need actually around 7 to 8 energy bars, or you will need energy bar plus like Glucon-D, or you will need Enerzal in water. So the energy bar will actually be a solid food, and you will also get some amount of glucose from your water or the hydration which you are going to take. So solid food will also be there, and then you will also have some amount of like you will have actually a lot of water in the summer time now. So water plus Enerzal or any other product like Fastenap or Glucon-D. So your water should also like, I actually would carry two kinds of water, like one water with Enerzal and salt, and then one bottle is like just plain water. So because generally I like to drink plain water also. So have one bottle with plain water in which you actually have nothing, and another bottle with water plus Enerzal or Fastenap or Glucon-D, which will actually give you water plus some amount of glucose. And then you also should have solid food like energy bar, chocolates, or you can also carry peanut butter and bread. You can carry small, quarter pieces of sandwiches along with you, and you have to fuel yourself. Yes. So this will work for a person who is not very like, doesn't want to have some weight loss kind of targets. But if somebody wants to also like has some weight loss targets, and also you actually what you do is you should have a good dinner on Saturday, and then Sunday you should not take that breakfast and then go on the ride, but you should carry some amount of solid food and also some amount like water and all. So but yeah, that you are on a weight loss goal, but that does not mean like you starve yourself and you do the entire 100 kilometer or 100 kilometer plus without eating anything, because that will drain you dramatically and it will reduce your speed after some time, and because your body will run out of fuel after a couple of hours. So yeah, means I can ride 100 kilometers without eating anything, but that is a different thing because I have been training for so many years and I've done a lot of cycling training. So my body can fuel itself by using fat, but not everybody can will be able to do that as a beginner. So so you have to understand these aspects of fueling, of solid fuel, and then solid food, water plus Glucon-D and fast enough. So this is how you have to fuel. And then of course in summer time you should actually carry a lot of water, and you will have to even stop to buy water or refuel your water bottles, refill your water bottles. So but yeah, so you will have to do that, and it will take 4 to 5 liters of water itself for a 100 kilometer ride in this peak summer time. So that is how I would suggest you should go for a 100 or 100 plus kilometer ride, and best is to start very early in the morning, like 4 a.m. or 5 a.m. and then, because you will be back before the actual peak heat starts. So, and it is less exhausting also that way. Okay, so you can keep asking me such questions, and I'm happy to answer these questions for you. Okay, bye.